That's not like a beautiful presentation, and I was wondering that, I don't know when the crusade started, but did it have something to do with the Moors going into Europe?
Yeah, like, so 1711, I don't know the exact date, but that's not necessarily my area. But it did influence the crusade. What was going on? It's funny because when we think of Europe, we talk about Africa in terms of tribes, and like we talk about Europe in terms of like nations, as if they were already nations. Like the same way that we created the idea of Europe, it wasn't Europe, it was individual territories and clans, and there wasn't a lot of economic growth and development. Like even the kings in Europe didn't have houses and castles. A lot of that came through the influence of the Moors. And we don't talk about that at all. We don't talk about, we like to believe that certain groups advanced in isolation, that Europe advanced to the degree to which Africa disadvantaged. And so it was really the exploitation of African resources, labor, humans that led to European advancement. That even in terms of naval know-how and machinery, a lot of that was learned from the Moors, but they just took it to the next level because they were trying to find more efficient ways to get Africans here. So they were driven by a different superstructure, but also mentality, because they had an early inception of, a desire for capitalism, I should say, the desire to expand their territory at any cost. And that idea is really kind of foreign in African traditions. Although there was some shared conquering, it was a general belief that the land belonged to God, like Allah. Like, you couldn't own the land, so you can't. And that, so it, that's why you don't see, even in the most advanced civilizations in ancient Kemet or Egypt and Ethiopia, you don't see the shift to capitalism, because the mindset wasn't the same as it was in Europe. And, I mean, some of it had to do with, well, I think some of it has to do with the nature of indigenous cultures, that when you are living, or when the first people are in an environment where their basic needs are accounted for, so if you're in a tropical climate of Africa or South America or et cetera, you can pick berries, you can get fruit, you can get trees and make your house, you can do whatever you want. But if you're in Europe and there's a short time frame where you can plant and harvest in order to get food because the climate changes, then for one, you're more focused on time. And since we talk about colored people's time, like, the deadline was real for them. Because if they didn't have a schedule largely regulated by the female's menstrual cycle, they would not be able to harvest land. It would have to be just trying to kill and hunt whatever they're going to eat. So they had to be more structured around a timeline and a time frame and getting things done in a certain time. And so their principal focus was the acquisition of the things that they needed. But when you have people in another territory who already have what they need, right, their principal focus is family and relationship, because they have what they need. Right. So they're interested in how they're going to relate to each other. And like, you see it in how we greet each other, you know, like everything about us is symbolic to the family. Everything we do is about, because we, alhamdulillah, we're blessed with not having to focus to the same degree on those immediate needs. And it creates a different mindset and subset that continues from generation to generation, where if you're thinking about conquest and exploitation and needing to get resources, then you can behave in one way. Like if you think about it, Africans and Europeans had access to a lot of the same materials. There's more resources in Africa than anywhere. So the gold, the copper, the diamonds, et cetera. But what we were doing with the gold and the metals, we're creating statues in the likeness of God. We weren't creating guns. Like, we got guns from, you know, we weren't creating weaponry in that way. And so it speaks to the mentality, the mindset to some degree of why when we came together there was such a clash, because you have societies that are organized very differently. Right. And even though, and it's not, I think that I hate the word of development and advancement, because it's relative to yours. Like, what you see as success and advancement, if you feel like if everything you're doing is trying to pay homage to something greater than you, then that might be advancement. But if you feel like with that same material you have to get your next man stuff because you don't know where your meal is going to come from, then it seems like technologically we're further along, but how much further along are you really? Right. Yeah.
I was going to say, it was a joke that most Native Americans selling land to, they would laugh and say, land belongs to God.
Yeah. Right.
And it was a statement I remember reading a book, and the Indians say, next you'll say, that's his airspace.
Yeah.
Which they do now.
Yeah. It's true.
Now,